You wanna go out?
Let's go.
Wanna go? Wanna go for a walk?
Let's go.
Wanna go out?
Like, crouch down low. So some house updates. Well, this was a while ago, but we did receive an offer on our house about 3 days after we put it on the market. We had a bunch of showings the weekend after we put it on the market, and one person said it was priced too high, but obviously it wasn't because we got a full price offer. So that's exciting. This past weekend was the inspection. I think the appraisal happened this week. I don't know. We don't live there full time, so I have no idea what's going on. But yeah, that's kind of where we're at. We also have a backup offer that's the same. So it's kind of crazy, but it's very stressful because, yeah, now we got to move out and we don't live there full time. Like, we live here full time in Brooklyn and we have a lot of stuff. So now we got to figure out how to store it, and also, like, when are we gonna do that? We have until April 10th to move out of the house, so that's where we're at. That's what's happening.
I'm just getting video of things happening. Well, you look good with house shirt on. Having your shirt off is X-rated.
No, I don't. I'm a man, so no.
Yeah, if those were my nipples.
Yeah, the internet would be all up in the flames. All up in a rage, a tizzy.
Okay, so we have some updates on the house. I look terrible. Our first offer fell through, because this buyer was just being so unreasonable. Like, I mean, this is my first time selling a house, so maybe I, like, don't know the process, and I would love to hear from other people who have sold their houses before, but we felt like the demands he was asking of us were, like, did not match how much money he thought he should get off because of, like, our inspection. So our house was built in the 1970s. It's very old. You know, it's like 50 years old at this point. It has a lot of problems. And here's the thing. Our township didn't have building codes until 2008. That's what one of our contractors told us. So a lot of stuff is not up to code. But a lot of stuff in our house was built prior to, like, was done prior to 2008. So it's grandfathered in. Like, we are not under any obligation to fix anything that's not up to code if it was built before those codes were in place. If we didn't touch it. If we touched it, if we changed it, then yeah, we need to bring it up to code. And everything that we touched, we brought up to code. So all of the stuff that we did, like, there was no notes about it on the inspection. So our kitchen is great. The downstairs bathroom is up to code, blah, blah, blah. The only thing this inspector said, which, like, I would love to hear from other people who do, like, house inspections, is he said that the cable railing should be taken down and replaced with something else because it's a safety hazard because kids could use it as a ladder. And I was like, that sounds like a fucking parent problem, not a me problem. Like, tell your kids not to climb on the fucking cable railing. And to be completely honest, our house is not super kid friendly. Like, this is not a house for little kids. This is a house if you have, like, older kids maybe, but it's not designed well for, like, toddlers. So I wouldn't buy that house if I had little kids. Whatever. I don't think this buyer had toddlers. I don't know, but that wasn't something he wanted fixed. I think he liked the cable railing, and I'm sure he thought like us. But there was a lot of just, like, stupid stuff that we were like, okay, yeah, like, we can fix that. But it's not worth 30 grand less or even 15 grand less. We had our guy who's been doing some of the work on our house, like since Peter and I can't be out there. We asked him to quote some of these things. He quoted us 6 grand. So you're asking for 15 grand off and you want us to do 6 grand of work for you? And it's like stuff like one of our pipes became disconnected. And it's the pipe for our outdoor hose. So, okay, yeah, we can fix it. It's not a big deal. Like, that would take Peter literally 10 minutes to fix. Oh, and the kicker was he wanted a licensed contractor to do all of this work. Now, like, yeah, that makes sense, right? You want a licensed contractor to do work. A lot of this stuff was not stuff that a licensed contractor needed to do. You could absolutely have a handyman do it. The thing that made me and Peter and my dad laugh is, like, it's really hard to get licensed contractors to come out and do work in the Poconos in a timely manner. So if this guy really wanted that, he was going to be waiting a long time to move into that house. Like, our closing would have been pushed back. The other thing that pissed us off is there was kind of this insinuation that we were being shady, that like we were hiding problems with the staging of the house. This made me fucking laugh because the staging of the house is how I decorated the house. We didn't stage it. Like, this is how I lived in the house. Everything we did in the house was for me, not for you. And you just happen to like it. Like, we weren't hiding anything. This was how we created the house for ourselves. Like, the problems you found, it's an old house. It's in the middle of the fucking woods. It's in the middle of the woods. You're gonna have weird problems. You're not in the city. It also felt like this guy was kind of in cahoots with the inspector. Like, this inspection was so thorough. Our inspection for that house was a joke. Like, this guy missed electric problems. So it kind of felt like the whole thing felt really icky. So we went back and forth a lot. It was really stressful. I was like having an eye twitch in this eye, which happens when I'm stressed because I was so fucking stressed. Wasn't sleeping. I just want to be done with this. Like, when I am ready to be over something, I'm fucking ready to be over it. So anyway, we went back and forth. We gave the guy like a deadline and it was our best and final offer. And it was a good offer. And he said no. So we terminated the negotiations and we went to our backup offer. So yeah, I'm so sorry. This vlog is going to be so long. Maybe I'll split it up into like two, but I'm gonna go to the gym now. Okay. Yeah, I think that's it for now. I'll update more later. We just got our documents notarized and we are 3 days from selling the house. For the last time ever. How do you feel about that? She doesn't care. She's always hated the house anyway. This isn't bad for one day of packing. Well, one day in like 3 hours. It's not bad. I feel like it looks like we haven't done much, but also a lot of the furniture's staying, so yeah. We're not moving it. So it is like 4 o'clock on Saturday, day two of, well, two and a half of like packing up the house, and I have just completely lost steam. It looks like there's a lot. There's like
bunch of stuff in the kitchen that needs to be packed still. It's just taking me forever, but I'm just so tired, so I'm literally just watching Peter load the U-boxes because my back won't let me do anything else.